Alright, so I've got the area wiped down with bleach just to sanitize everything. Open up the hose clamp package here. And now you have these fittings here that came with the RV, is to adapt to the factory water heater. I'm going to go ahead and just reconnect those. Put them back up into the, I guess you would call this PEX. And what they do is they just fit on here, it'll slide on here, and then another part just screws down to form a tight seal. Picked up other fittings so I can adapt it to another hose so I can go out to hook it up to the water heater on the outside. Now I've already kind of pulled the propane line out. This is going to be the basis of where the new water heater is going to be sitting, because I don't want to have to cut this or put new fittings on it or anything like that. So I'll go ahead and take these, stick them on here. Make sure there's nice and tight. Luckily for these white fittings, there's a little rubber gasket in there, so you don't have to worry about any Teflon tape or anything like that. So they're nice and tight. I'm going to take this clear hose that I got. The reason why I got this is because I needed to be able to move it around and figure out where exactly the water heater is going to go. And basically I'm just going to straighten that out as much as I can and then cut it in half. So that way I have two full lengths. It's 10 feet, so supposedly 10 feet, it doesn't look like it, but 10 feet of hose to work with, 2 5-foot lengths, one for the water going to the water heater, and one coming out. It actually looks like there's already a kink right there, so I'm just going to cut it right there. That's pretty close to halfway. Looking cuts. Let's see if I can square them up. Okay. And this one. I know I should get an actual hose cutter. I'm going to make certain ones, but doing all this on an extreme budget. So just work with what you got. Alright, so I'm going to take these lengths of hose. Oh yeah, it's going to be plenty. I'm going to put this on here. The sad thing is these are flathead screwdriver, or to use to tighten it, and I cannot find mine anywhere. I've got like 5 of them. It's like a 10 millimeter or a 9/16 ratchet or a socket. You have a bunch of them, but you can't find them. But it looks like there's a 1/4 inch hex on there, so I think I'm gonna go get that nut driver and use it. So I'll be right back. Okay, so yep, perfect. I'll get this put on here. Always put the clamp on first, just makes things a lot easier. Wish it was warmer out. It'd heat up this vinyl tubing a little bit before doing this. That would make things a lot easier. But hey, it's supposed to get to 35 degrees today, so. Considering what it has been, within the past couple weeks, it's not bad. Not even wearing gloves, so. There we go. And then for the other side, I got these two. They'll connect right to the water heater on the outside. Elbows here are plastic. I don't want to risk breaking them. And somebody just realized I don't know which one's the inlet and which one's the outlet. So that's going to be interesting. Can't trace it back to the pump because the pump's covered in heater ducts. All the lines are. Maybe I'll just go out and get everything else hooked up and then hook up the water lines last. Alright, so outside we go. Alright, so I've already kind of placed this where I want it. Because I wanted to base it off of where this propane line is. So I went ahead and put a screw up here to mount it. I'm gonna have to figure out some kind of, you know, some plywood, some insulation for right here. So let's go ahead and hook up the propane line. I've already tested this to another propane fitting, so it seems like it'll fit on this one just fine. It's the same kind of fitting. Thank you. Same thing with taking the other one off. You have to use two of these. Hold one side steady while you tighten down the hose, or else it could damage internal parts. Don't really want to do it very tight because the actual sealing surface can get warped if you do that. You get too tight. So the best thing to do is just tighten it up. Then when you get propane to it, spray it with soapy water or some kind of cleaner, mild cleaner that is. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and put the other fittings on here. Just double check, make sure they're gonna fit on both of the inlet and outlet. Yep, we are. Now, on these ones, I'm going to put some Teflon tape on there for some sealing. Just to make sure that they're not going to leak. Definitely wish it was more. Realize the bad thing is if I click this on, I won't be able to screw it onto that. So yeah, pull this back off. We're just gonna have to go and steal the generator from the other camper, charging its batteries right now. We have to steal the generator and plug it in over here so we can get some water flow. Let's see which direction the water goes on this thing. So be right back. Alright, so got the generator over here. I've already hooked up the propane as well. So I'm going to take this mild cleaner here and just spray this real quick. Make sure there's no bubbles coming out. Right, everything looks good. Drag out these hoses. Just because I don't know which one the water does come out of, and I'm going to go turn on the pump to get water going through here. So I'll do that. I'll leave the camera running. Maybe I'll zoom in a little bit to see. And adjust the view. There we go. Okay. Turn the pump on. There's one thing I forgot. I did get to see water come out of here, but over here, the inlet for the pressurized water there is no one-way valve on there, so I gotta remember to plug that up. But anyways, we'll get you back over here. So now I can see that this one right here will be the water inlet, and this one will be the water outlet. Did have, oh, here it is, Teflon tape. It's gonna be interesting trying to get it up there, but I think I'll just do it this way. Just take a length of it out. Same with the other one, go ahead and just get it on there. A little bit of tightening. Now try to fit this sucker on. Try to warm up the hose a little bit. I'll be back. I'm gonna go get the get the plug for that inlet over there. And we'll go ahead and pressurize the system, see what happens. Alright, so one thing I did forget, for the igniter, it's all electronic. It takes two D-sized batteries. Opening right here, drop it open. It's clearly marked which side here is positive. Back. It's got little tabs to hold the battery in. There's that sucker back up, hopefully. Just that. Alright, let's go inside and pressurize the water. Take you in with me. Alright, so turn the water on. I hear it pressurizing. There's water flowing in there. Shut this off. Okay, the system's pressurized. Nice. See if we can get in here. I don't see any leaks. Yeah, I'm gonna, there's a little screen in here, I'm gonna take that off. This is just pretty disgusting. Hold on. Alright, let's go ahead and just take this cap off here and get all this crud to just run out. Oh, it's absolutely disgusting. Cold water. Whew. Purposely put a bunch of bleach in there to flush out the lines. Everything else out. Everything just gets flushed. We'll just double check that. Okay. No, here. It's, oh, the bulbs are broken. Getting warm water. I don't know if that thing's even firing up. seem like it. Cold water. Now I don't mind just running this thing. It's got probably about 10 or so gallons in the freshwater tank. Alright everyone, so we got it working. Still a little bit of a leak here. I think I'm gonna grab my channel locks. I think they're inside. Oh, here they are. I'll just tighten this down a little bit more. But just for testing purposes, had some water in the system, but ran out of water. I'm gonna have to loosen this up and straighten it out. There's a kink in here now, but I had to turn the water flow down in order to get it to work. So once we get more water in the holding tank, in the clean water holding tank, we'll retest it and see if we can get some of the flow to go up a bit and get some decent pressure out of it. Alright, so there we go. We'll call this job complete. Hope you enjoyed this video. Bye.